Please, all of you, mute your audio and video. Hope I am audible and visible to everybody. If so, please raise the hands so that I can get the acknowledgement. Okay, thank you. So, like scheduled, we will start the class now. I hope you have gone through the previous lecture videos, what I have shared with you. So, this class will be on the examples of RL series, RC series and RLC series circuit. I am Mr. Nagraj DC, Assistant Professor, Department of EEE, BMSIT and M, Elanka, Bangalore. Okay, so today I will be dealing with the numerical on this series circuits when connected to the AC supply. Okay, so I have shared you the sheet where there are four numericals that we are trying to solve today. So please keep those numerical statements as along with you, because I cannot dictate all the numerical statements. It will consume time and it will affect the recording memory even. For that reason, I have shared those numerical statements to you already. Okay, so the first numerical we'll start with. Okay, hope everybody is ready. So please bear with the local arrangement. In the time of this crisis, I hope this will be useful. I will be sharing this video after the class or by the end of the day, and also I will be sharing by today or tomorrow the solutions for all these numericals what we will be seeing if it is not clearly visible in the lecture. Okay, so first numerical states that a resistance of 10 ohm and an inductance of 20 millihenry are connected in series across a supply of 230 volts 50 hertz. Find the current, power factor, power consumed by the circuit. Also draw the phasor diagram and write the instantaneous equations for voltage and current. Okay, so this is the numerical statement. So as per the given statement, it is a series circuit. A series circuit consisting of resistance and inductance okay, with the resistance of 10 ohms and inductance of 20 millihenries. Connected across the supply of 230 volts and 50 hertz. So this is the given circuit. Now I should be finding what is the current, what is the power factor, what is the power consumed by the circuit, and to draw the vector diagram that we will see once we find the circuit parameter. So the current, let this be E, the RMS value. The mentioned voltage values will be always the RMS value. So therefore 230 volt is the RMS value. When this gets connected to the circuit, a current of I amperes of RMS value flows into the circuit. So now I can write current I is equals to, okay, I can write current I is equals to, with Ohm's law, E divided by Z. From Ohm's law, I can write current I is equals to E divided by Z, or more specifically, magnitude of current I is equals to magnitude of voltage divided by magnitude of resistance. Sorry, impedance. Okay. Now, what is the voltage? It is directly given 230 volts. And what is impedance? So here, impedance Z is equals to under root R square plus XL square. This already we have seen in the previous RL series series circuit lecture. Okay, so impedance is equals to R square plus XL square, because when we draw the impedance triangle for the RL circuit, this will be R, this will be XL, and this will be Z, where this is the power factor angle phi. So please don't forget impedance triangle and power triangle. So those will be useful for us in almost every numerical that we solve in any with any of the methods we use. Okay. So therefore, remember the impedance triangle for RL circuit, remember the impedance triangle for RC circuit, and remember the power triangles for both RL and RC circuit. Okay. So from this, I can write Z is magnitude of Z is equals to, using Pythagoras theorem, under root R square plus XL square. Now I need to find out what is XL. Okay. So XL is equals to omega L, or equals to 2 pi FL. Okay. Now substituting the values of XL, it is 2 pi into 50 into L is 20 milli. So XL will come out to be, well, I don't have solution, I need to calculate here. 2 pi into 50 into 20 milli. Okay. So XL is 6.283 ohms. XL is 6.283 ohms. Okay. And R value already I have, it is 10 ohms. Therefore, magnitude of Z is equals to under root 10 square plus 6.283 square equals to 11.81 ohms. So magnitude of Z is equals to 11.81 ohms. Okay. So magnitude of Z is equals to 11.81 ohms. Okay. Therefore, current I is equals to 230 divided by 11.81. So this is equals to 19.47 amperes. So the magnitude of current is 19.47 amperes. So that is the first point to be calculated. The second point is power factor. Okay. So power factor is cos phi. We know that cos phi is equals to R by Z. I know the value of R, I know the value of Z. So therefore, cos phi equal to R by Z, I can write R as 10 ohms, Z as 11.81. equals to 0.846. Power factor is 0.846. Okay. So next I need to calculate the power consumed by the circuit. So power consumed by any AC circuit. Power consumed in any AC circuit is always equal to P is equals to EI cos phi. So power consumed is P is equals to EI cos phi. I know the value of E, I know the value of I, and I know the value of cos phi. Substitute the values. 230 into I is 19.47 into cos phi is 0.846 equals to 3791.78 watts. So this is the power consumed by the circuit, RL circuit. Next point. Now we need to draw the phasor diagram. Okay. So I hope you have gone through the steps that I told to draw the phasor diagram. Explained in the previous video lectures. Now see here, the voltage applied is 230 volts, and generally we take voltage at reference, that is initial phase angle of voltage we consider to be 0 degrees, unless and until it is mentioned that it has got some phase angle initially. Okay, so 230 volt I consider it to be starting at omega t equal to 0, and current I flows through this R, I will get the voltage drop I into R, and I will get the voltage drop I into XL. Okay. Now, as mentioned in the previous videos, I told that in a series circuit, current remains common in all the components, hence current has to be taken as the reference vector for drawing the phasor diagram. So for any circuit, the thumb rule is the quantity that remains common in all the components has to be taken to draw the phasor diagram, so that with respect to the common quantity in the circuit, what are the phasor relations of various other quantities, those are present in the circuit. Okay. Therefore, current is common in the series circuit. Hence, I take current as the reference vector. I take current as reference vector I. Little bit down I will draw. I will take current as reference vector I. Now this current I is flowing through the resistance of 10 ohms. It creates a voltage drop of I into R volts. And we know that across resistance, the current and voltage are in phase. Therefore, the voltage I into R will fall in phase with the current I. So I will draw the voltage vector I into R. I will draw the voltage vector I into R in phase with the current I. And we know the assumed positive direction of vectors is anticlockwise. Now the same current I flows through the inductance and create a voltage across it I into XL. And it will create a voltage drop of I into XL, and we know that in resistance, or sorry, in inductance, the voltage will be leading the current by an angle 90 degrees, or current will be lagging behind the voltage by an angle 90 degrees. So, okay, therefore, I will plot the vector I into XL leading the current I by an angle 90 degrees. So I will draw I into XL leading the current I by an angle 90 degrees. Now this is representing various vectors, those are present in the circuit. Now the resultant is the voltage, which is the sum of two voltage drops added vectorially. Okay, that I will be taking as the resultant E, which is equals to I into Z, which is equals to I into Z. Okay, and the angle here is phi. Angle here is phi. So this is the vector diagram for the RL circuit. Okay, the instantaneous current is written as I is equals to Im sine of, yeah, you can observe voltage is taken with reference, with initial phase angle 0 degrees. Therefore, I should mention the phase angle of current with respect to voltage. I can observe here, current I is lagging behind voltage E by an angle phi. Therefore, I will write I is equals to Im sine of omega t minus phi. Okay. Im sine of omega t minus phi. Now, I will be calculating all the vector diagram components. So please, when in any example or numerical, if the vector diagram is asked to draw, then don't simply draw the vector diagram with this IZ, IXL, IR like this. You have to calculate the value of I into Z, I into XL, I into R and phi. That is the complete vector diagram for the given circuit. So now we will calculate what is I into XL. So first, what is phi? So phi is equals to, you can write cos inverse. Okay. What was the power factor value? 0.864. Sorry, 0.846. Okay. It comes 32.22 degrees. Okay. 32.22 degrees. Okay. Then I into R. It will be I is 19.47 into 10 is equals to 194.7 volts. Okay. I into XL is equals to 19.47 into the value of XL. Value of XL was 6.28. So this is 62.8 volts. Sorry. Not 62.8. 6.28 into 19.47. It is 122.27 volts. Okay. Now what is I into Z? I into Z is equals to, or this E is equals to under root I into R square plus I into XL square. Now I into Z is nothing but my E. Now E is 230 volts. So the resultant of this vector, okay, using Pythagoras theorem, should come near to 230 volts. So it is under root 194.7 square plus 122.27 square. It comes to be 229.9 volts. Okay, so which is nearly 230 volts, because we don't consider all the decimal points, hence we get slight difference or deviation in the decimal values or in the last digit of the voltage value. So it is nearly equal to 230 volts. So it ensures that what all calculations we have done are correct. Okay, if anywhere we have done mistake, then we would have not got E equals to 229.9 volts. Okay, and phi is equals to, it is 32.22. If you have space, you can write the values here. IR is equals to the value, IXL is equal to the value, IZ equal to the value, phi equal to the value. I don't have space here, so I will keep as it is and leave it for you to write. Okay, so this is the end of first numerical, which gives us the method to solve the RL series circuit. So we will see the second numerical now. Okay. I will share the solution sheet also, okay, later at the end of the day. If don't be hurry up in noting down the things, please look into how we are going into the solution. Now the second numerical, an AC circuit, AC series circuit consists of a capacitor of 150 microfarad in series with a resistance of 5 ohms having a supply of 220 volts 50 hertz. Okay, determine the current, power factor, power consumed, reactive power and total power. Also draw the vector diagram and power triangle for the circuit. Okay. So an AC series circuit I have. Having a capacitance of 150 microfarad and a resistance of 5 ohms connected across a supply of 200 volts, 50 hertz, 200 ohms, 50 hertz. Okay. Now same thing we need to follow. We should be calculating the current, power factor, power consumed. Okay. So now I know the circuit is capacitive. Okay. Current I, or magnitude of current I, is given by magnitude of voltage E divided by magnitude of impedance Z. Okay, where magnitude of impedance Z is equals to under root R square plus XC square. Okay, so the impedance triangle for RC circuit is like this. This is R, XC and Z. Okay, so the impedance triangle for RC circuit is in the inverted form of RL circuit. So R, Z and XC. Therefore, I can write Z is equals to R square plus XC square under root. Whereas XC is 1 over omega C or 1 over 2 pi fc, 1 over omega c or 1 over 2 pi fc. Substitute the values, xc is equals to 1 over 2 pi into 50 into 150 micro. So my xc will come out to be 21.22 ohms. My XA will come out to be 21.22 ohms. Okay. Now, therefore, Z is equals to under root pi square plus 21.22 square. It comes from 21.8 ohms. 21.8 ohms. Okay. Therefore, current I, magnitude of voltage is 200 divided by impedance is 21.8 ohms. Comes out to be 9.17. Amperes. So the current is 9.17 amperes. Okay. So next is power consumed. So general power consumed equation for any AC circuit is P equal to EI cos phi. So P is equals to EI cos phi. I don't know what is the value of cos phi. So first we will see what is cos phi. So cos phi is equals to R by Z. So it is phi divided by 21.8. It is 0.229 or 0.23. I will take it nearly 0.23. So cos phi is 0.23, and what is phi? I will calculate here only. It is cos inverse of answer 76.7 degrees. Okay. Now I can calculate what is the value of power consumed. This is equals to 200 into 9.17 into 0.23. Is 421.82 watts. So power consumed is 421.82 watts. Okay. So what is the next point to be calculated? Power factor, power consumed, reactive power. Okay. So reactive power, we know from the power triangle, we can draw the power triangle for RC series circuit, which is also asked in the numerical. Okay. Phi, it is EI cos phi, it is EI sin phi, and this is EI. So reactive power is EI sin phi. So EI sin phi is equals to 200 into 9.17 into sin phi is sin of 76.7. It is 1784.8 VAR. Please don't write watts here. Okay. The unit of reactive power is reactive volt amperes. It is not watts. Okay. And the total power is E into I. total power. Is E into I is equals to 200 into 9.17. So E into I is equals to 1834 volt amperes. So that is the total power. Now if you take the resultant of EI cos phi, EI sin phi, you will get EI is equal to 1834 volt amperes. Okay, that you can do on your own. Next point is to draw the vector diagram. Now again, this is a series circuit. There is a voltage drop across 5 ohms. I take it as I into R. There is voltage drop or voltage across 150 microfarads, that is I will take I into XC. Okay. Now since this is a series circuit, current is common quantity in all the components, I take current as the reference vector. Okay. So I take current as reference vector. Now this current I is flowing through R, creating a resistance drop of I into R. Now we know that in resistance, the voltage across resistance and current through resistance are in phase always. Therefore, I draw the voltage across resistance I into R in phase with the current I. And the voltage across capacitor will be always lagging behind the current through capacitor by an angle 90 degrees. Because current in capacitor will lead the voltage across capacitor by an angle 90 degrees. Now already I have my current vector lying on reference axis. I need to place the voltage vector of capacitor with respect to this current vector. Hence, the voltage vector I into XC can be placed lagging behind current I by an angle 90 degrees. So this is I into XC. Okay. Lagging behind the current I by an angle 90 degrees. And this is the direction of rotation of vectors. Okay. So now, the resultant of I into R and I into XE is E, because the total voltage E is getting distributed across two components R and C. Hence, voltage vector IR and voltage vector IC, resultant of these two will give us the voltage vector E. Okay. The value is 5. Okay. In the similar way, what we have done in the previous numerical, please calculate what is I into R. Calculate what is I into XC and calculate what is I into Z. Now when you calculate I into Z, it should come near to 200 volts. I will leave this part for you. Okay, I will not do that here again. Okay, so calculate I into R, calculate I into XC. Phi already we have calculated, it is somewhere around 72 degrees. Calculate I into Z. Now this I into Z should come nearly equal to 200 volts or come exactly equal to 200 volts. So this is the justification that my vector diagram is correct, and also the justification that all my calculations are correct. Okay. So this is the end of numerical 2 with RC circuit. We shall move to the third numerical, which is on RLC series circuit. I hope you have gone through the RLC series circuit lecture, what I have shared with you. Okay. Some of you may were having difficulty in viewing that because it was a Google Drive link. Okay. Now I have opened the link for or the file for everybody who is having the link. Everybody can access to see that video. If you are watching that video in mobile phones, then please download Google Drive app from the App Store. Okay. Without Google Drive app, that file will not be open. Okay. You can't view that file or that video until you have Google Drive in your mobile phone. Okay, if you are using laptops, then automatically in Gmail you can place that link, copy that link to your URL, and directly it will go to your Google Drive, and there you can get the video. Okay, or else you have got the link to my YouTube channel. Okay, I have shared a link to my YouTube channel. all the videos what I will be recording for the lectures, whether it is for first sem or second sem or sixth sem of my subject, all my videos will be available in my YouTube channel. Okay, so you can simply go to that YouTube channel. All the videos that I have recorded will be available there. Maybe there will be a delay of one day in uploading those videos, but within 24 hours you will get all my videos available there in my YouTube channel. Okay, and if you subscribe that channel, you will get the notification automatically whenever I upload any material into that. You can directly view the material in a click. The third numerical, a series circuit consists of an inductance of 0.1 Henry and capacitance of 120 microfarad in series with the resistance of 12 ohms. Okay. Determine the nature of circuit. Nature of circuit here means whether the circuit is resistive or capacitive or inductive. Current in the circuit and power consumed. Draw the phasor diagram for the given circuit. And the supply voltage given is 220 volts, 50 hertz. Now I have a RLC circuit, RLC series circuit. So this RLC series circuit is connected across the supply of 220 volt, 50 hertz. The value of resistance is 12 ohms, inductance is 0.1 henries, and capacitance is 120 microfarad. So the current flowing through this is I. So the first point what is asked to do is to determine what is the nature of the circuit. So nature of the circuit cannot be viewed just by observing the values of RL and C. We need to know what are the values of reactances. Okay. So obviously there is a resistance present here. Therefore this circuit cannot be a circuit with pure inductive or pure capacitive nature. So this will be either RL circuit or an RC circuit effectively. Okay. So therefore first we need to find what is the value of XL and what is the value of XC. So XL is equals to omega L or 2 pi FL equals to ohms. Okay. And XC is equals to 1 over omega C, 1 over 2 pi FC is equals to 26.52. Okay. So here we observe XL is 31.41 ohms and XC is 26.52 ohms. Therefore, my XL is greater than XC. Hence, the inductive reactance is more than the capacitive reactance. Therefore, this circuit will behave inductive. Okay. You can write since inductive reactance is greater than capacitive reactance, the circuit is inductive. Okay. So, because XL is greater than XC, circuit is inductive in nature. Circuit is inductive in nature. Okay. So that is the first point what we wanted to calculate. Now the current in the circuit. Now current in the circuit. Before that, I can draw the vector diagram directly. Anyhow, it is asked, then we will draw it now only. So current I, again it is a series circuit, take current I as a reference vector. I into R, I into XL and I into XC. Okay. Now I into R will be in phase with I. I into R will be in phase with I. So this is I into R. I into XL will be leading the current I by an angle 90 degrees. I into XL will be leading the current I by an angle 90 degrees. And I into XC will be lagging behind the current I by an angle 90 degrees. This is I into XC, okay, by an angle 90 degrees. So the length of vector I into XL, okay, will be greater than the length of vector I into XC, because XL is greater than XC. Therefore, I into XL is greater than I into XC. Therefore, the resultant is given by this is E, which is equals to I into Z, and this is I into XL minus I into XC. I can write I into XL minus XC. Okay, I into XL minus XC. This is the angle phi. Angle phi. Therefore, by taking out the impedance triangle, I will take out the impedance triangle Z R XL minus XC. So the effective reactance of the circuit is inductive because XL is greater than XC. That is XL minus XC. Therefore, Z is equals to under root R square plus XL minus XC square. That is Z is equals to under root 12 square plus 31.41 minus 26.52 square. So that comes out to be 12.95 ohms. So the impedance is 12.95 ohms. Okay. Therefore, I is equals to E by Z, or magnitude of I is equal to magnitude of E by magnitude of Z. This is magnitude of Z is 220 divided by 12.95. So I is equals to 16.98 or 17, nearly 17 amperes. So current is 17 amperes. So next is power consumed. So power consumed is again EI cos phi. Power consumed. P is equals to EI cos phi. I don't know cos phi as of now. I can write cos phi is equals to R by Z. So cos phi is 12 divided by 12.95 is equals to 0.92. So when the power factor is near to 1, the circuit, though it is inductive in nature, but it is more resistive. Okay? It means that the power factor is near to 1. Okay? So in the RL effect, R is very much more effective than XL and XC. So you can observe here, XL and XC are near to each other. 31 and 26 are not much far away values. Okay? They cancel out each other. So they cancel out to the maximum extent. So therefore, only R will remain. Okay? Hence, the power factor will come near to unity. If the XL and XC values are very near to each other in an RLC series circuit, my power factor will be very near to 1. Okay? That observation you should be keeping in mind. Therefore, P is equals to EI is 220 into 7, sorry, 17 into 0.92. Please. So P is equals to 3465.6 watts. So this is the power consumed by the circuit. Okay. So phasor diagram is already been drawn. So this is the end of numerical, third numerical. Okay. So time is, we have another 15 minutes. We can solve the fourth numerical also. It is quite simple, not so difficult. Fourth numerical will help us to understand the nature of RLC circuit. Okay. Or how we can vary the value of XL and XC for my requirement. So fourth numerical, a series circuit is having RLC components with resistance of 15 ohms and inductance of 30 millihenries. Calculate the current, power consumed and power factor of the circuit when circuit behaves resistive. Okay? When connected to 200 volts, 50 hertz supply. What is the value of capacitance when circuit behaves resistive, when circuit behaves inductive and when circuit behaves capacitive? Okay? So the value of capacitor is not given here. The value of capacitance has to be calculated depending upon my requirement of the circuit behavior. Okay. So I have a series circuit. Having R, L and C components. Okay. Where R is 15 ohms. L is 30 millihenries, but I don't know the value of C, I will take it as C itself. Okay? And the voltage, supply voltage is 200 volts, 50 hertz. 200 volts, 50 hertz. Now calculate the current, power consumed and power factor of the circuit when circuit behaves resistive. So we have seen in the analysis that if the circuit is having inductive reactance XL greater than capacitive reactance XC, the circuit behaves inductive. When the inductive reactance XL is lesser than capacitive reactance XC or XC is greater than XL, the circuit behaves capacitive. And when both the reactances are exactly equal, the circuit behaves resistive. So for me, for circuit to be resistive, XL should be equals to XC. For circuit to be resistive, it is strictly for RLC series circuit. For RLC series circuit, for circuit to be resistive, my XL should be equals to XC. Now, I don't know the value of C, so I can't calculate the value of XC. But I can calculate the value of XL because I know the value of L. Therefore, XL is equals to, okay, 2 pi FL or omega L equals to 2 pi into 50 into 30 milli. Okay. it is 9.42 ohms. Okay. So therefore, for circuit to be resistive, XC should also be 9.42 ohms. Okay. Therefore, XC is also equals to 9.42 ohms. Okay. Now with this, I have to calculate the current, power consumed and power factor. So current I is equals to E by Z. Okay. Current I is equals to E by Z. At or when circuit is resistive, when circuit is resistive, Z is equals to R. Because XL is equal to XC, therefore XL minus XC or XC minus XL will cancel out. Okay. So this is R, this is XL, this is XC. So because XL is equal to XC, these both will cancel out, only R will remain, and that will be is equals to Z. So therefore, when circuit behaves resistive in a series RLC combination, the impedance will be equal to the resistance. Therefore, I is equals to 220 divided by 15. Is 14.66 amperes. Okay. Second is power factor. Power factor means cos phi is equals to R by Z, which is nothing but R by R and is equals to 1. So power factor when the circuit behaves resistive is 1. Okay, because that is R and R by R is 1. Okay, that is one reason. Other reason is my resultant voltage is equals to I into R, which will be in phase with the current I. Therefore, phase angle of the resultant voltage is equals to 0. Sorry, the angle phase difference between voltage, resultant voltage and the current is 0, and cos 0 is also 1. Okay. So cos phi is equal to 1 and phi is equals to 0 degrees. Therefore, power consumed is given by power consumed is given by P is equals to E into I, cos phi. So cos phi is 1, power consumed is equals to P is equals to E into I. Power consumed means P is equals to EI cos phi. Okay. And this cos phi is equals to 1. Therefore, P is equals to E into I. That is 220 into what is the value of current I? It is 14.66. So it is 200 volts or 220 volts? 200 volts. But in the previous case also I took 220. Okay, you take it as 220 volt. 220 volts. Okay, so 220 with 14.66 means 3225.2 watts. That is the power consumed. So this power is nothing but the total power. The capacitive reactive power will cancel out with inductive reactive power. Hence, the total power is nothing but the power that is consumed by the resistance or power consumed by the circuit. Okay. So, this is one part. Okay. Now, what is the value of capacitance when circuit behaves resistive? So, first case, value of C when circuit behaves resistive. So for resistive nature of circuit, my XC should be equal to XL, and this already I know is equals to 9.42 ohms. So therefore, 1 upon 2 pi FC is equals to 9.42. Calculate the value of C. Therefore, C is equals to 1 over 2 pi F into 9.42. So this is 338 microfarads. Okay. Now if the circuit should behave inductive, if the circuit should behave inductive, my XC should be less than XL. That is, XC should be less than 9.42 because frequency is remaining constant. So therefore, my inductive reactance will remain constant. So XC should be less than 9.42. That is, 1 over 2 pi FC should be less than 9.42, or C should be greater than 1 over 2 pi F into 9.42. That is, C should be greater than 338 microfarads. If the value of capacitor is greater than 338 microfarads, then the circuit will behave inductive. Third point, capacitive, very simple. If value of capacitance is greater than 338 microfarad, circuit is inductive. So value of capacitor should be less than 338 microfarad for the circuit to be a capacitive. Okay, you can, in the same way, XC should be greater than 9.4 XL, or XC should be greater than 9.42, 1 over 2 pi FC greater than 9.42, or C should be lesser than 338 microfarads. So when capacitor is less than 338 microfarad, circuit behaves capacitive. When capacitance is greater than 338 microfarad, circuit behaves inductive. When capacitor is exactly 338 microfarad, circuit behaves resistive. Okay. So this is the analysis of RL, RC and RLC series circuit. I hope the lectures what we have discussed are useful. This I am taking for my proof that I have taken the class. Documentation is more important than the work. Okay. So here we see the various natures of the circuits when connected to the alternating current source. Okay. So this is the end of series circuit analysis. In the next forthcoming lectures, either in lecture videos or in this live classroom, I will be dealing with the parallel circuits and how to represent the impedance in various other forms. So here we have calculated the impedances only at its magnitude part. Okay. So there is one more representation of impedance, which is in the form of complex value. Okay. How to represent impedance in complex value, and how to analyze the circuit using complex value impedance analysis. That all things we will be dealing with in forthcoming classes. Okay. So I hope this is useful. Okay. Parallelly, I have recorded one more video, but that video is having slight bits and number of videos are more. I could not record it continuously. I will be sharing that video and this video. Whichever you feel more useful, you can follow. Okay. and all my videos, lecture videos will be available in my YouTube channel. You can subscribe. You will get directly the notification the moment I upload anything there, and you can go through. And in forthcoming days, I will be uploading many other videos which will be useful technically with respect to electrical engineering, whether it may be in the form of fundamental understanding or it may be in the application understanding. Okay. So I hope we shall end. It is exactly 12. So we'll end the class. Thank you. Okay. And I thank my younger brother Suraj also, because he helped me to set up all this in my house. Okay. So this is all of one of my room in my house. So with locally available things, we are trying to reach you out. Okay. So please appreciate the efforts of every teacher who is putting to reach you with them, either in the form of a material or in the form of lectures. Please go through the materials. Please go through the lectures. Go through the textbooks. Try to read. Don't sit idle. Okay. Because there is a long gap between the time we have stopped the regular classes in the college and the moment we come to the classes back to the college. It will be a long gap. So therefore, don't waste the time. Go through the concepts. Wherever you feel difficulty, you can text me directly to my number personally or in the group if possible. Okay. So we'll end here. Thank you.